But there are two things about it. One, he has the experience with the Republican Party. He knows Republicans. He's been talking to them for a number of years. On the other hand, people who know him best have expressed some great doubt about his leadership ability.
Well, he's got, you
know, Coburn, for example.
Yeah, he's got
Scarborough, for example.
Yeah, he's got more baggage than a Macy's luggage department, as most people have said. Part of the problem has always been his personality. People think he can say something off the cuff. He gets angry. I think some of that has been seasoned. I've seen him in Iowa, and you have a conversation with him now. When I used to have conversations with him sometimes 5 or 6 years ago, he seems a little settled down and not as angry or not as on edge as he used to be. Mm-hmm. But that is something I think that is still questionable. Can he sustain this? Not whether he has the organization, but does his personality and does his background, can he sustain a race without exploding in the midst of it? And I think that's the open question.
And explosion would be simply saying something that was so outrageous, it would bring him down. Because the people who've been brought down were brought down because of failures within their own, you know, on one hand with Kane, a personal problem with Perry, with debate problem.
Well, it's interesting to me that if you took an XY axis on this race, and one side of the axis is competency, ability to see the person in the Oval Office and as President of the United States, and the other axis is authenticity. That's what the Republican voters are looking for. They're looking for somebody that's authentic, that has a sort of distinct, deep set of conservative values, but also is competent. Michelle Bachmann, Rick Perry, and Herman Cain all looked authentic, but then dropped on the competence side. Newt Gingrich is seen as much more competent than anybody else. And I think as the debates go on in the next few debates, people will continue to see that they could see him as commander-in-chief.
But is he authentic?
I think that right now, people view him that. People view him as the perception that he's authentic. I do think he has a core set of principles, whether it's economic conservatism or other sets of principles. He has, as you know, he has changed on a few issues. But I think people get a sense, much different than Romney, they get a sense that he has a core set of beliefs, that he's not going to just shift in the winds, in the political winds. He's not going to just say something to get elected to office. And so I think he retains that. That's a vulnerability, if exposed, could hurt him. But I think at this point in the process, interestingly enough, the calendar is huge, is a huge advantage for him.
So he does well in Iowa. He may do well in New Hampshire. He's leading in South Carolina, and you're off to the races.
And the calendar heading into the Christmas holidays right now, because right now you only have about a week or 8 days left of real vetting and a real conversation. And
to slow him down.
And after that expires, people go and say, I don't want to really hear negative stuff. I'm going to go away. And then they show back up on January 2nd, and the next day is the Iowa caucus, which he is now considerably ahead.
Join us online at charlierose.com.